Although the flow of depolarization and repolarization through the myocardium is a three-dimensional process, it is very important to realize that each of the leads of the ECG examines the movement of these forces through the heart in one plane only. In fact, based on the plane in which they analyze electrical events in the heart, the 12 leads of the ECG divide into two groups of six. The six chest leads, also referred to as the precordial leads, V1 to V6, examine the flow of depolarization and repolarization through the heart in the horizontal or transverse plane, while a second group of six leads, the frontal leads, examine these electrical events in the vertical or frontal plane. We will first deal with the transverse group, the chest leads. The six chest leads, V1 to V6, are placed on the surface of the chest wall in an arc, from V1 in the fourth right intercostal space to the right of the sternum, to lead V2 in the fourth left intercostal space to the left of the sternum, and then at roughly equal intervals to lead V6 in the fifth left intercostal space in the mid-axillary line. These leads examine the flow of depolarization and repolarization in the transverse plane from these perspectives. If we take a representative transverse section through the chest, you will appreciate that with the heart in anatomical position, the atria lie posterior to the ventricles, and the right ventricle lies somewhat anterior to the left in this plane. V1 and V2 therefore face the surface of the right ventricle. However, note that they also face the much larger muscle mass of the interventricular septum. These leads are strongly influenced by electrical events in this structure, and V1 and V2 are therefore often referred to as the septal leads. V3 and V4 face the anterior wall of the left ventricle, while V5 and V6 face the lateral wall of the left ventricle. Modern machines present the printed ECG readout landscaped on an A4 piece of paper, and the signal from each of the chest leads is recorded on the left-hand side of this A4 ECG readout in numerical order, as shown here. We can consider the frontal leads in two groups of three: the standard limb leads, leads 1, 2 and 3, and the augmented vector leads, AVR, AVL and AVF. The frontal leads examine the flow of depolarization and repolarization through the heart in the frontal plane. If we take a representative frontal section through the thorax, it will help you understand the perspective of each of these leads on cardiac electrical events. To remember the position of all six of the frontal leads relative to the heart, use lead 1 as your reference point. Lead 1 looks directly at the heart from the patient's left-hand side and defines 0 degrees in all further discussions of the frontal leads. Lead 2 looks at the heart at an angle 60 degrees further clockwise from lead 1, while lead 3 is positioned a further 60 degrees clockwise from lead 2. The readout from the standard leads, leads 1, 2 and 3, are recorded down the right-hand side of the ECG paper, as shown here. We are now left with three further leads to remember, the augmented vector leads, AVR, AVL and AVF. AVL looks at the heart from the left, L is for left, but at 30 degrees anti-clockwise from lead 1. AVR looks at the right side of the heart, or is for right, and just like AVL, it is 30 degrees above the horizontal relative to lead 1. As AVL and AVR are set at 30 degrees off the horizontal plane, you can think of them as the left and right wings, or vings, of the ECG. AVF looks straight up at the inferior surface of the heart, and is therefore at 90 degrees clockwise from lead 1. Think of AVF as looking straight up at the heart from the feet. F is for feet. On the ECG readout, recordings from the augmented vector leads are positioned between the standard leads and the chest leads, from AVR to AVL and down to AVF at the foot of the page. The lead perspectives and angles illustrated in this diagram will become very important to us when we go on to discuss disease states and the concept of the cardiac axis in section 2. Now that we understand the perspective of all 12 ECG leads on cardiac electrical events, you may ask, can we use the simple principles outlined in video 2 to build a predicted normal 12 lead readout? Well, the answer is yes, certainly for the chest leads, but for reasons which hopefully will become clear to you, this approach is slightly less satisfactory when dealing with the frontal leads. Understanding the readout in the frontal leads, particularly the morphology of the QRS complexes, requires a slightly more sophisticated but still comprehensible approach. The electrical forces of depolarisation and repolarisation are vectors. And before you go on, we would urge you to watch the next two videos outlining some principles of vector mathematics. We will then use these principles and what we have learned so far to construct a predicted normal 12-lead ECG. Before leaving the topic of lead perspectives, there is one more important point to consider. For reasons which will become obvious to you in subsequent sections, in addition to the division into frontal and chest leads based on the plane in which they analyse cardiac electrical events, the leads are also considered in groups which face adjacent anatomical areas of the heart. Three of the frontal leads, 2-3 and AVF, face the inferior surface of the heart and are termed the inferior leads. Leads V1 and V2 face the interventricular septum, while leads V3 and V4 face the anterior surface of the left ventricle. These four chest leads are referred to as the anterior or anteroseptal leads. The left lateral leads face the left lateral surface of the left ventricle. The designations shown here will be very useful to us when we consider disease states. But do not make the mistake of thinking that these groups of leads analyse cardiac electrical events only in the anatomical areas indicated. As you will see shortly, the lead groups analyse electrical events in all areas of the heart in the relevant plane from the perspective indicated by their designations.